Okay, so here we are. It's middle of October. I think it's the 17th or 18th. Just doing a quick October tour of how it looks like. It's not in the best of condition, but that's mostly because it's October. But here we go. There's some the remains of the one lot of sweet corn. This was the glacé ones for saving for popcorn. And then I've got some dwarf bolotis there. Hopefully they are going to have enough time to get bigger for saving for the seed for winter food. This is the fennel. Oh, how I love the fennel to go to seed. The birds love it. Just look at those lovely seed heads. Gorgeous, gorgeous. I've saved the fennel seed not only for sowing but also for sprinkling into soups, stews, whatever, even bread if you want to. That's aqualegia growing amongst them and a few dandelions. This here is my pea bed. I've just cleared it and mulched it. It's got compost on it and now it's got mulch on it, ready for early February March plantings of the seedlings. And then there's my carrot bed that's been under the under that mesh ever since I sowed the seed. I've got a random beetroot growing in there. So we've harvested some of those. They're really quite big. If you perhaps can see the heads in there, they're looking quite good. These are cauliflowers. Now I sowed two beds of cauliflowers, one here, along here, and one up there. There's only one that survived up there, and one were normal all the year round collies, and one was Romanesco, and I just don't know which is which. But I see I've got some, what's that called? With the blue flower, can't think. Anyway, that the bees love it. But along here, in front of these cauliflowers, I had another row of carrots, and I grew Bedfordshire Champion onions from seed and planted out the plants along here, and they were amazing. So next year I'm going to grow more of those. This is the beginning of our dead hedge. Don't know if you've heard of dead hedge, where we put all the twigs and sticks and everything all along here lengthways like this in between these posts, and it rots down, but you can keep adding, like when you prune your trees, you know, the prunings will all go in there. And it's a lovely habitat for the little insects and little animals. And this is the remainder of my herb patch. You can see there, this is tarragon, and it's still growing around here. Now that is a bed there. I had beetroot in there. That's all been harvested amongst the cauliflower that's not there. That's our little cloche there. This is Bramley. We planted this last year. We've had two apples. Hoping that will grow, keep growing and produce. This is the cherry tree. Our cherry tree was over on that plot where the pear and the plum trees are, but it was all too close together, so my Stanley, he dug it up. And and all the long roots, and he dug all the channels along here and buried the roots. And look at it, that was last, not the winter just gone last year, but the winter before that. So last year it produced cherries, it survived, it was amazing. That's our fig tree in the background. We've had tons of figs, but as you can probably see, lots of figs on there that are not going to mature, but we've had bags full of. They're in the freezer, and I'm going to make some jam later on. And these are our autumn raspberries on this second plot. This is our original plot here, and then we got this strip here about 4 years ago. So these raspberry canes went in for the first time not last year, but the year before. Last year they didn't really have anything on them, but we've had loads this year. And all around here we've had lots of winter squash. Some did okay, some didn't. But as you can, and this patch here, we had lots and lots of onions, and they were amazing. But it's, and we've got cabbages, as you can see, they haven't done too well, but they're still there, they're still alive. We might get a few leaves from them when it's time. And but this needs a good weed and a good mulch, as does it all. But we had the squash growing in here. We've got several paths, and this was where the fence was, just here, where that separated the two plots. So I had a flower bed, my shrub and flower bed along here. So these, some roses, and of course the Orientis verbena. Another rose in, there's another rose there, and this has a pretty little pink flower on it. And this is some red robin, another I can't remember can't remember the names, never mind. So yes, and these are two beds. These have already been mulched for the winter, even though they've still got the sweet corn. We'll cut them off at the ground and leave the roots in, because it feeds the soil. Because we are, if I haven't said, we're no dig. We've been no dig now. This will be, we first composted 3 years ago in December. The whole plot, all of this plot and that plot, we composted it all completely, and we haven't dug since. So in between, you can see the paths are ready. They've got wood chip on, but they're ready to be re-wood chipped. And I've got a few lettuce, random lettuce, and some kale coming along in there. More aquilegia and more brassicas coming along in there, which I interplanted before. But if you look here in this, this is the path. This has been mulched with some weed and wood chip for 3 years now, and it's lovely compost. And we're going to dig up some of that compost and put on our beds, and then we, because it's after 2 to 3 years you can do that, and it breaks down and makes a good mulch. So we're going to do that, because we, these are our compost bins. So we've got three bays. That's where we bring it to when we're gardening, and then it goes into this one. And after 3 to 4 months, or when it's been broken down and right to the top again 2 or 3 times, we then put it into here. And this is our last move. We only turn it the once. This hasn't broken down very well, this this time. So you can see, we should be using that now on the ground, but it hasn't broken down too well because it's been too dry, we think. So we've just added a bit more wet kind of green to it, and we'll leave it until March now. This is, when that's done, we move it into here, this base, so that we can use it from here. And so this is what we're using at the moment to put on our beds. And we would have had all of that in here, but it's too late. Anyway, so that's the peas will go in there, and then once the carrots are up and the cauliflowers are finished, this bed will be weeded and mulched and compost on the top. And I'm now at the moment about to sow the aqua dulce broad beans that overwinter, so I shall sow them into little pots. And when the plants are about 2 or 3 inches tall, probably about December, then they will go in the ground, and I'll cover them with a fleece. And these two beds will be cleared. I've got a few carrots in there. Come in. I don't know whether I had carrots up here or not. I think I did have a few carrots. Yeah, there's a few carrots here. And the fennel will be over, but the brassicas will continue. Okay, so I think that's it for this plot at the moment. That's the shed and storage. We've got a big tank for the water there. This is our original plot now. This is two big blackcurrant bushes. This has had a good prune, but I needed the loppers to prune in here a bit more. So here we come round here to our main shed, our main big shed, and we've got a table outside where it's a bit of a dumping ground really, but it's just outside the shed. Give a quick look in there. It has two chairs that we usually take out in the sun and bits of storage, and that's our loo. Yep, that's our loo. Okay, now this is the fig, which now needs a good prune. All the leaves are dropping. We have to take all of these off. All of these have to come off like that, because they won't come to anything. If you don't take them off, we won't get anything next year. And if you can see on the end, that shoot, that's where the new ones will start to come. And we'll start to get some of these nodules as well. There we go. So every time I come up, I take a few of these off. Just drop them on the floor. Sometimes I scoop them up and put them in the compost bin. And this is our, what we call the potting shed. My son bought me that. Got a bee buzzing around my head. Got a few plants along here, but this is all going to come out. This has all got a bit left to ruin. I've got one of these little bird. When I'm in there, when I prick out my plants, watch the birds pecking the seed from there. And these need planting up again in the, that's full of water. But this is our little bee hotel. But I think it's probably needs emptying now, because I don't think there's been any activity for a year now. So we'll probably empty it and let it all start again. This is the shed that came with the plot. And we got lots of bits and bobs in here. This is where we tend to put our garlic and onions and other bits and bobs. Yep, lots of storage space, but we've got an awful lot of stuff that needs sorting out, chucking away, things from the outside like this, we need to sort out and get it away in one of the sheds, because we've got room if we clear it away. And this is Tabury here, growing along here. It's actually, I think it was a bird, probably dropped the seeds, and the root is actually behind that shed, which we can't get to. So I'm trying to train it out here a bit. We've had some Tabury's off it in the past, and that's our next door's plot. They have a lovely plum tree there and apple tree. Right, so around here, this was a bit. That's a beautiful iris when it flowers. It's a bit sunken, this, so we're going to clear all this out and add lots of soil to bring it up level to ground level. And this is the lemon balm, which is, oh, I can't get rid of it. It grows everywhere, look. So, grows everywhere, it's all over here. This is a lovely red climbing rose. Beautiful, beautiful when it flowers. And that's the Montana clematis. And we also have a grapevine in here, not doing that well. Well, there's a few grapes on there, and they are actually really sweet. Very sweet. Lovely. That's a strawberry patch over there. So I'm walking on my bed, because you can actually walk on no dig beds. But yep, that's the strawberry patch. I moved these strawberries here last year, so we didn't pick them this year, but next year we'll be able to pick. I've weeded all of that. That's got to be mulched. This is the path of which I'm mulching, because you can chop and drop your weeds and walk on it on your path. It's got wood chip underneath, but I'm hoping it to break down. And we've got a bit more work to do on these paths here. They need wood chipping now. This was a potato patch last year. Along that fence, I've put a row of elephant garlic. And this needs, we grew the potatoes in hay. Just laid the potatoes on the top and then covered them with hay, and they grew in the hay. This is the remainder of it. So we'll just give this a good mulch with a bit of compost, leave the hay. I might scrape the hay off actually and use it for mulch somewhere else, but it needs a good compost. And then I'm thinking of growing more onions on here. Right, these were barlotties, climbing barlotties, which didn't do very well at all. There's a gooseberry bush there. This gooseberry bush has disease, which that's the oldest big one. So Sunny is going to chop that out this autumn, and we'll give the ground a good weed and mulch and clear it of everything. So there'll just be the rose bush in there then. And I've got a new little gooseberry cutting, two actually, and that I'm perhaps put back in there. This one's lovely. It has little pink gooseberries. They're so sweet, like dessert. And this is a couple of black currants bushes. These are two red currant bushes. And I had some spare tomato plants, so I put them along there. They didn't do too great actually. Oh, I've got a few green ones there. And I've got a couple of really big ones there. They're called Big Mama. So, and these are the raspberry canes. This is our main autumn raspberry patch. These are our other RBC tank here. Big water tank here. Another one there. This is our greenhouse, which is ripening the tomatoes at the moment. That's got to be cleaned out. This is the blueberry tub. Got three blueberry plants in there. This one got a bit shriveled with the heat this year, even though it was watered. I've got parsley and chervil. These parsley especially grows like this all winter. I'll put it in soups and stews all winter. Handfuls of fresh parsley, because when you pick it, it just grows again, keeps growing. It's amazing. If there's one herb apart from mint that I would recommend anyone to grow, it would be parsley, because it's so good for you. So here are the raspberries. They're about coming to the end, really. Look at the top. Yeah, there's one or two coming. I picked these a couple of days ago, so there's not that many now. There won't be many more pickings. So incinerator. Now this is a new patch. Well, actually this is another blackberry bush. This is an old one, and we've got to cut some of this dead old wood, give it a good prune back, this one. It might not survive, I don't know, because it's very old. It's at least 10 years old, that. And then we've got a couple of red currants there. Okay, so yeah, so along here where that post was, this was the other border. This is our polytunnel. First winter, blew away twice. You can see by the tape, it's ripped. You can only open the door the other side halfway now, because it blew away in the gales. So we're gonna put some boards or something around the outside, perhaps to prevent it from taking off this winter. This is a couple of plants of sunchoke, some of you call it, but it's what's it called? You'll know what it is, who's looking. We call it sunchokes, artichoke. It's the Jerusalem artichoke. Look, I've got a flower on there. But I don't think although it looks as if there might be something pushing up out of there, I think we'll probably end up leaving that this winter, because I've only put that in the spring. So this is the other side of the polytunnel on our original plot. Carrots, I've sowed carrots in here 4 times and none of them germinated, apart from the last lot I sowed. And I kept watering them, but it was so dry. So we've got a few coming, so we might have a few. I've got lots of calendula over there. And this is our tree cabbage. This is amazing. These lovely leaves. You cook them like cabbages. They never heart up. They just keep growing. I think they grow for 3 years, so you need to re-sow. And this is our second year. But the leaves, they're just so amazing. So amazing. And got leeks here. And some sprouting broccoli in the middle there. That's celery, which took a long time really to get going because of the dry weather. I kept watering it, but just too dry. And I've got a few more carrots over there and a few more brassicas. And lots of bits of fennel everywhere, but that's cosmos. That's because I just love it. You can plant it anywhere you want. So that's really, well, the end of our original plots. The pear tree, I've got two little apple trees and a plum tree. And that we let go rough, really, because it's for the birds and for other animals. Just where those square hoop things are, you can see the white plastic ridge on the floor, on the path there. But those plants there are their everlasting cauliflower, the broccoli, they call it. Well, it's perennial broccoli, but it's white, like, and you get a head of like a cauliflower on the top. And I just can't wait. I sowed the seed and put those plants in, but only four survived. So this is beetroot along here. This is where I had my squash climbing up this contraption along here, both sides, this side and the other side. And here we've got Covolo Nero and sprouting broccoli, Brussels sprouts that nearly died in the heat. This is more Brussels sprouts, but they're coming on nice now. They've got baby ones now. This is more sprouting broccoli. We've got to make the cage a bit higher. Got a random tomato growing in there. We also had a random squash, but it's finished now. We had a few, I planted some late beans because the others failed so badly. They didn't do too well either, but the nasturtium did, and this was all beautiful, beautiful morning glory. I put a few more beans on this side, but again, they didn't really do much. But the nasturtium did very well. So, and this was the other side. I had some plants in here. Tansy, this is tansy, and it's got a bit tangled up with the net. Yep, this is tansy. That is amazing for the bees, and I grew all of those from seed. And here we've got tabry. There was a fence like this all the way along, and we kept it until it got up to the black currants and then whilst the tabry was fruiting, we got pounds of tabrys off there, pounds. But we've chopped it to the ground, and we're not sure whether we're going to keep this or not, because there's also this end. We think this is not the tabry, but loganberry. That's what we think this one is, and it needs tying in or doing, but you cut it back to the ground in the autumn, as far as we know. So we've done that before and it's worked. So, and then here's the rhubarb going over. We've got three bits of rhubarb, and we've had quite a bit of that this summer and autumn. This is Taunton Dean kale, perennial kale, and you take these little leaves, pick these leaves. This grows all year round. So if you haven't got cabbages or kale plants like this in the ground, you have just one of these. Well, we've got three of those, but I could do with another one of these. But I'm going to take some cuttings, because these little side shoots you can take off and plant. There's one there I can take off, and I'll put it in a pot so I can get some more, because it's really delicious. And this is another perennial kale, and actually perennial spinach. It goes to seed like this. You can eat these little leaves here, put them in amongst your vegetables, or you can put them in salad. These seeds, as you can see, when they go dry, you pick them and you can use the seed the same as quinoa. So I've got another one there, I've got another one there, and this big one over there. That one, the seed is ready now to harvest. There is the globe artichoke. That needs a good mulch. And I've got horseradish in there. That's it. that's horseradish. And then here, I have got mint, and but I've got lots of bulbs. This needs, the sticks need clearing. But I've got lots of flowers that I put in there, and bulbs. Got lots of snowdrops. Look at this teasel. This was a self-set by the birds, so we left it because the insects, it's so good for the insects, really is. There's the ladder where Stanley picked the last of the pears. And a little bird table here. Yep. There we go. So, this is the plum tree. This tree isn't, this is only 2 years old, this plum tree. Look how tall it is already. We keep chopping the tops off them because we don't want to get too high. And we've got those two little apple trees that are amazing. One is Discovery, that one is Discovery. So they're not keepers, but it was absolutely covered. The branches touched the ground. So it's had a prune now. And this one is the Braeburn. And they're keepers, and they're slightly sharper. Anyway, here is, in here, you won't be able to see, but that's Swede. Now in the summer, the Swede, with the heat, it died to a crisp. I kept watering it, and in the centre there was just a tiny bit of green, and now it's coming again. Oh, there's a few green tomatoes there. I've just taken off this bed here. As you can see in here, I've got one Swede. Oh, it's just one at the moment. I can't even find it. It's plumping up anyway. So I might get a few little ones. This is a celeriac. Again, this bed was full of celeriac. But last year our celeriac were amazing, almost as big as footballs. There's a few little ones in there, look. I don't think it's going to be amazing this year. And then we've got all this comfrey growing around here. This is our plot number 3, of course. Goes up there to that shed at the back there where those pots are, and that shed at the side. That shed at the side is our shed that goes along with this, and the big square water tank. That's the archway that we put in. So here we've got curly kale, and we've been picking this for about 3 months now. So hopefully it's going to carry on through the autumn, winter. This is, I thought it was cabbage. And it looks as if it's cauliflower or calabrese even. These have all been undercover, these nets, ever since we planted. And here was the cabbages. We've had several little cabbages off here. And I've now mulched this, and I've planted my garlic in here. It's like a hole there. I hope there's not been any animals trying to dig it up, and I'll just put a few comfrey leaves on the top just to give it a little bit of feed. Got tons of comfrey, and we've got two little bins here. We've not had that much rubbish off this plot yet, but this will all be cleared all along the fence here. Stanley built this new fence and gate all the way up, and we've had sunflowers which didn't grow. They were beautiful though. They didn't grow that tall, but they were lovely, so pretty, and with the cosmos as well. I think this is cup and saucer cosmos. I save all my seeds, and so that's all from my seed. That this is another brassica bed. We think this is cauliflower in here, or calabrese, one or the other. this is the second tomato bed which I haven't got round to cutting down yet. I've took all the tomatoes off now, so I'm cutting them down to the ground, and I'm putting the stalks into the dead hedge, taking out the canes, weeding, and then going to mulch it with compost and plant onion sets along here. This was another one, and I've already done this one, so I've left in the calendula, and there's nasturtium there, and this is basil, a bit of basil, and that is, in actual fact, cosmos. That's not flowered, it's just been there, really. Anyway, I've put homemade compost on here, so that's all ready to take my onion sets. I'm going to leave that those plants in there, they'll die off soon enough. And this is another bed here, another brassica bed with about 6 plants in there. Actually, I'm going to move this my barrow a bit forward because it's there. That's ochre. I had a few ochre corms which I planted in pots, and only one I planted out in the ground, 2 or 3, but only one survived because of the dry weather. So I'll probably just use that for seed next year. Just either dig what there is there, dig it up, and And this is the other side, the other squash bed. We had loads of squash coming all along here, loads. Echicurry, we had baby boo, lots and lots of small summer squash. And the echicurry. Oh, we had trombocinos and early crookneck, little yellow ones they are. It's been so prolific, it really has. And I had some spare brassica plants, so I just planted these in the ground amongst them when I planted the squash plants. And these look like they're cauliflowers as well. So it looks as if I had quite a lot of my own homegrown cauliflowers. And again, look, you can still see the morning glory growing at the back up there. Taking lots of seed for next year. These were beans, late sowings of beans. I thought I might get a late crop, but I haven't. And there's more beetroot here. This was my second planting of corn. This is like a rainbow corn, again for popcorn. But I don't think I've had several cobs, that's a firm one, but they've not gone a different colour. And see what the colour this is. See if I can get some of the leaves off to see what it looks like underneath. Oh, it is different colours. Oh, look at that. Just look at that. That's a good one then. So I've got some good seed there, I can save. You perhaps dry it and see if we can make popcorn with it. So that's a good one. That's what I wanted it for. The corn that we grew for the cobs to eat, that's all finished and cut down. But on each corner of this bed here, I've had Romanesco courgette, and they grew massive. They've come right over here to the fence. And I must have had 30 courgettes off each of those plants. I had another courgette just here, which was a pale green one. I can't remember what it's called, but very smooth pale green, and that was equally delicious. It tasted a bit like the Trombettino, and they're our three favourites actually, and the Itchikuri. We like the Itchikuri, but they keep all winter. They're a long keeping winter squash, if you like. Our other winter squash, we didn't have many of that. This is our tank, water tank in here. See if it's filling up a bit. Oh no, there's a little bit in there, not a lot, about 6 inches. So this is the last of our plots. Okay, this big area here, we haven't managed. This was the person that had it before us, all of this area was an old asparagus bed that had been there for years and years, so it wasn't producing anything anymore, and you can see the humps here. So this is all the fence that came down from along there. We've got to sort out all of this. We've got quite a lot of stuff to sort out and put away. This is all the squash plants, and this is a baby. Look, this is the baby early crook, what they call early crook neck. Yeah, did really well with the squash and the courgettes, but I guess people mostly do well with those, don't they, courgettes. But I've put lots in the freezer with garlic and onions. Our onions were amazing, so I've got lots of onions in the freezer, and that I've processed down, and so I haven't got so many that are dried for storage as onions, because I usually use the onions to go into the soups and stews, and I've made the bases already and put them in the freezer with courgettes as well. This is the other little shed on the first shed, and these are some onions we've got left stored. I've got a few in the other shed as well, but this is the Bedfordshire Champion, what I grew from seed. Look how big that is. It's amazing. And these are some pears. Oh, there's one, they're going off a little bit. Pears. We've got loads of pears in the freezer, processed down. We've had pear crumble. Last year I made pear piccalilli, and there's some apples. That apple's underneath there. No, nothing under there. A few apples left, not many, and a few pears. So we'll get some more of those and perhaps make some more pear piccalilli. This is another area that needs sorting. Another little wheelbarrow there. And that's a view from here. It's so beautiful this time of year. It's my favourite season, September and October. And this is our neighbours. They dig their ground. They don't grow anything in the winter. They're new, but they keep it all nice. They like to come and sit in it as their garden. And it's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. Got a few trees there. They've got a piece of log on there as a table. That's quite ingenious, that. Yeah, they've got a few brassicas and got some parsnips over there and carrots. But this was all their potatoes. That's what they mainly grow. And yeah, they've rotivated that several times, and over the other side. Herbs at the front there. Got a few Brussels there. So yeah, this is ours. Huge plot really when you look at it. I didn't show you my parsnips. I had on the, we've got a little pond. We're not really meant to have ponds, but we've got another strawberry. This is our old strawberry patch, but what I did was I weeded it and I replanted some of the runners, so hopefully we'll get a few off there still. This is our little pond, which looks like it needs some more water. It's got a lot of weed in there. I know we bought the plants. There's about three plants in there that we bought. Probably needs a bit of thinning out a bit. But we've got toads and frogs in there, and we also get birds and all sorts coming in to have a drink. This is a cage, which actually was the end of a rabbit run. So it's got, we had to put wire on the other side, but it, so this lifts over and closes it, but there was a bird in there that had got under the edge over there where all the little animals and the frogs and that come in and out, but a bird had got in there and they couldn't get out, so we opened it and it flew away. So we now leave it open, and I've got to plant up some plants around here to give it a bit of shade in the summer. So I've got a few more brassicas here. Grew chickpeas just here, and some, just a handful of main crop potatoes, which didn't grow too badly. A few more over here. This little patch here was Charlotte potatoes. Had a few of those, so I grew those, and they weren't too bad. There is chard. A few more bits of beetroot there. And these are my bean wigwams that I grow for dried beans to eat through the winter. That one's meant to go like that, that's why they're still on the plant, hoping that there's time for them to dry out. There's a few there. This looks as if it's just got a few at the top there. We also had climbing red dwarf, and they were amazing. We did get quite a few of those. This is our little asparagus patch. I bought 3 crowns, about 6 years ago. One survived. And then I bought 2 or 3 more crowns, and one survived. And then I sowed some seed, and I planted out the little seedlings last year, and this is one of them from what I planted last year. So soon I'll be cutting that all down there. So I've got about 8 in there now all together. So I'll be mulching and weeding and cutting that all down. And my grandson Alfie, this was his garlic and onion patch last year, this little strip here. So we had a few off there. I've got to weed that, mulch that, probably put some cardboard on that because there's quite a lot of grass in there. And this was full, from here upwards, was full of our red and brown onions. Amazing. And I inter-sowed with carrots along that edge up there and along the front. Here there's one, or two that have survived that are still there, still growing. This is a self-set hollyhock. But these are my parsnips. I inter-sowed the onions with the parsnips, and they're doing really quite well. This shouldn't be on there, but I don't think there's anything underneath it, no. So there we go. That needs a good weed, and then that'll have a good weed once we get the parsnips up. They're looking quite big, some of them. Not sure if you can see them. No, they're too deep, really. Can't see any heads at all. But even if we get a few for Christmas, that's all we need. So that's it, I think. This is a very long video, but it's the first one I've done. These are flowers, these are chrysanthemum cuttings that I've done. Along here I've got various plants that will come up in the winter, autumn and winter, ready for the spring. So I've got other plants in here, and this lavender was amazing. That's another tansy there. So we have quite a lot of this dock that is a bit of a nuisance, and the grass obviously, but I haven't really had the time to spend lots and lots of time, but now I'm free and I can spend more time here. This is the wildlife area, but it's a bit rubbishy actually. That's our Christmas tree from last year. And I had this chair here, my old jacket here. I had this chair here because in the summer it was the only spot that was breezy and cool. So this is where I used to come. These are logs here for all the little animals. They nest in there over winter. It's a lovely habitat for them. So I've got to get these pots moved as soon as possible because they'll soon be setting up home. We don't want to be moving stuff in November, not really. Anyway, that's it. So, suddenly built that fence and the bins, the compost bins. And this is lovely sage that we've got growing here. This was one of our sweet corn beds, and a patch over there was a sweet corn bed as well. And calendula we've got. I'm saving the petals for the calendula, drying them to do various things, but that's another video. But that's the lovely sage plants there, and another parsley over there. Another parsley in there. These Californian poppies have been amazing. Look at the colours of them over there. Beautiful. Beautiful. Look at that colour. Nasturtium. Gorgeous, isn't it? This awful lemon balm. I mean, it is nice. It smells nice, but it's very invasive because it's like mint, which is becomes invasive. Another parsley plant there. Lots of parsley. This was the area where we come and sit. So we've got the fire thing there. This is my granddaughter's kitchen. We've got a barbecue. It's a bit of a dumping ground at the moment. That's our table there. And this is a bench where I put a lot of my seedlings and plants in the spring to get them used to the cold. So that's it, really. Little herb. We were going to have an ice pond once, but then they decided we were all to get rid of the pond, so we still put it in the ground and filled it with herbs. So that's our herb pond. We've lost the wheel of the window. And a little bench here to sit on. Oh, look at that fungi growing in there. To put some mushroom corms in there. That's what mushrooms grow from. Okay, so that's it. Thanks for watching. Sorry it was so long. Oh, I didn't show you into the polytunnel, did I? Oh, I've got another little thing here.